Hey guys, welcome to DevOps School. In this video tutorial, we are going to teach you about Terraform, which is a quietly revolutionizing DevOps by changing the way infrastructure is managed and making it faster and more efficient to execute DevOps projects. After going through this tutorial, I promise you that the concept and understanding of the Terraform will be absolutely clear to you. But before we begin, let me inform you a few things about us. DevOps School is one of the leading platforms which offers DevOps, cloud and containers technology training and certification programs for freshers and established professionals who wish to update and consolidate their skills in the dynamic IT scenario. We ensure that our training solutions are delivered by highly experienced domain experts with practical working experience in various verticals. You can join our all training programs globally through online platforms, and if you're looking for classroom workshop, then we have regular batches available in Hyderabad and Bangalore. Check out the dates and enroll with us for our upcoming batches. For more info, link and contact details are mentioned in the description below.
What is infrastructure DevOps? Okay. So what we do in infrastructure DevOps is primarily the infrastructure that is needed for the cloud environments. We spin it up with a lot of automation behind it. Okay. So when I say a lot of automation, we use a lot of tools like Terraform, and we use Terraform primarily for creating the infrastructure and then managing the infrastructure with the Terraform. So this course, whatever we are going to discuss right now, is primarily an introductory course around Terraform. Okay. So what I do here is I will create the infrastructure, like whatever the console that you see right now on my screen right now. This is AWS management console. Okay. I hope all of you have some experience or some understanding of what is cloud and how to create infrastructure on cloud environments. Okay. Now, when I say that, you should be able to do some basic understanding like creating, launching an instance, all these things in AWS or Azure or anything like that, even VMware. Now, if you have to launch a machine, like a simple EC2 machine using manual installations, yeah, all the process that you see here is just creating them through manual steps, right? Now, why do we need Terraform? Okay, so going back to my environments that I worked in the past, okay, we used to have at least 1000 plus servers on our infrastructure. Now, when you have a lot of servers and a lot of networks and a lot of automation behind them, the way you manage all these servers and everything is through some kind of automation behind it. Okay. So it's not a smart way to create the instances, manage them through a manual implementation. Okay. You need some kind of automation in the background that will take care of creating the instances, managing them, okay, and dynamically creating the environments as and when you need. Got it? Now, to solve that problem, when I say dynamically creating all these things, like creating EC2s, okay, creating EC2s, managing them, creating the volumes, creating key pairs, okay, VPC. I hope you know what is the EPC, which is virtual private cloud. So creating all those things, all these things through some kind of automation. Now, to solve that problem through automation, we have something called Terraform. Got it? Now, what is Terraform? Terraform is a tool which is primarily used for creating infrastructure through code. what is infrastructure through code. Okay, so whatever the cloud environments that you see right now, creating them through some kind of automation, which is Terraform, and then write all these services and everything that you see here through code. Okay, I'll show you some sample templates and everything. Okay, let's go through some. Right. One minute. Okay, this is a good example. So in this example, what you see here is nothing but a sample template of code, okay, for creating a simple AWS security group. Got it? So this example here, all it does is create a simple security group until here through Terraform template. Now this is written here through code, right? Okay, so what we are doing here, creating the security group, creating the instance. Okay, here we are creating another instance here. Okay, we are creating another instance here. So what you are trying to do, you are trying to express your infrastructure, which is actually creating instances through some kind of automation, which is through code. Got it? Now that is exactly what is infrastructure as code. Okay, so to do that, you need something called Terraform, and first and foremost you need to install Terraform. Okay, now it's very important if you are using something like a Mac PC, okay, Mac OS or something, what you should do, you should install through brew search for Terraform, and then simply install Terraform. Okay, if you say brew install Terraform, automatically it will install Terraform for you. Okay, so once if it is installed on your PC, then if you simply say Terraform hyphen version, it will say the version of Terraform that is installed on your system. Got it? So that's how you do it. Now, if you have a Windows machine, okay, how you will do it? How will you install? Okay, you follow this link. Chat. Okay, you follow this link, terraform.io, downloads, and you go to this installation binaries. Click on 64-bit downloads, 64-bit binaries, and then you can simply install it. Okay, if you have a Linux, if you have a Linux-based PC, you use this thing. And once you install Terraform, you should check for the version that is installed. Okay, why? Now, once you install Terraform, you should say something called help. These are all the various basic commands that are available on Terraform right now. Okay, so far, any questions? No questions? Okay. So now what I will do, whatever you see here, creating these instances, we will try to start manage this infrastructure through Terraform. Okay. So now let's go through some resources. Okay. So I explained very clearly what is infrastructure as code. I like to use only the material that is provided by the real software vendors that are available there. Like if you are going to deal with Kubernetes, you go directly to the documentation provided by Kubernetes only. Okay. If you deal with something like Terraform, I strongly encourage only use the documentation provided by Terraform only. Because the reason being the whatever the code and everything, whatever the instructions that they have, they're always up to date and their API versions are up to date, and your whatever you try out, they're expected to be working really good. Okay, so so are you practicing anyone right now by any chance on your PC right now? Whatever I'm doing right now.
No, we are just listening.
Okay, that's fine. So I explained what is infrastructure as code. Now, when you are dealing with the infrastructure as code, okay, I showed you a practical example where what are the infrastructure that you have, you're expressing your entire code through some kind of, you're expressing your entire infrastructure through some kind of code, right? Now, when you're doing that, okay, the benefit out of Terraform is it is platform agnostic. Okay, what is platform agnostic? Which means this Terraform code and the language that you learn, that the CLI that you learn, and whatever you write here, okay, it is useful for multiple cloud vendors or multiple infrastructure vendors. Okay, now here all you are doing, you're just mentioning your provider as AWS. Okay, but going forward, what will happen? So what you see here, whatever the code that I'm showing it here, it is good for all you change. If you change the provider from AWS to some other cloud, the DSL, I mean, whatever the format that you are using, okay, is pretty much similar to any cloud that you use. Okay, so the cute thing about Terraform is you learn it once, you apply it multiple times. Okay, so for example, like the environment that I am working in my job right now is we have multiple clouds, AWS, Azure, and all these things. Now, there are multiple tools that are available for AWS, Azure. For AWS, use something called CloudFormation. When it comes to Azure, use something called Azure Resource Manager Templates. Okay? So you have to learn a separate set of languages for all those tools, for all those clouds. Now, what is the disadvantage of that? That means you have to keep learning for every single cloud that you're going to use. Now, what is the benefit of Terraform? Benefits of Terraform is you learn it once and then you apply it to multiple clouds that you're seeing right now here, which is AWS, GCP, Docker, all these things. Okay, what is the benefit out of it? You learn it once and then you apply it multiple times. Okay, and all these templates, you can post them in a location like GitHub. So I hope you know what is Git and how to work on Git. Okay, now okay, so let's go through each and every sections of Terraform here. Now, I showed you how to install Terraform, and then once you run Terraform-help, you will see the various options that are there and the commands that are there to actually check various sections in your you run various commands on your system. Okay, 1 minute. Okay, so now, so these are all the various commands that are there. So tomorrow, if you are practicing Terraform on your PC, I strongly encourage to explore all these commands. So Terraform apply, for example, is a command where you use it to create the infrastructure and apply it directly onto the respective cloud provider that you are working on. For example, you are using a provider called AWS, right? Now, to implement it to AWS, you say Terraform apply, and you pass the template that you are writing. Whatever the code that you are going to have, you just pass it there. Got it? So that's the first thing. Now, next thing. So there are a lot of commands like that. So look at the basic description given there. builds or changes infrastructure. Okay. Next is console. Interactive console for Terraform interpolations. So destroy Terraform managed. So basically to tear down, if you want to tear down any infrastructure that is already created, then you use a command called Terraform destroy. Okay. So env for workspace management. So like that, there are a lot of commands which I will delve in later sections, but these are important. But this is the way that you should look for if you need help. Got it? That's very important. Now let's go back. Now let's go into each of these sections. So what is the workflow of creating this entire cloud infrastructure? Okay, so what is the work? What is the workflow? Workflow means the sequence of actions that are taken during the infrastructure creation, like creating EC2 instances, virtual machines, applying them, all those things. Okay, so what is scope? There are four important things: scope, other, initialize, plan, and apply. What is scope? So scope is nothing but the resources needed for a simple project that you have. So for example, if one of you tomorrow, your job is to simply launch a simple virtual machine. Your scope is nothing but you're creating a virtual machine in your project. That is your scope. Okay. Other. So author means nothing but who is the person and the configuration file who is creating this infrastructure. Got it? Next, initialize. Okay. So basically initialize means run Terraform init in the project directory with the configuration files. This will download the correct provider plugins for the project. Got it? Which means where are we right now? We are under users HLR. Let's create a directory called Terraform. CD Terraform. Why do you need it? For it to go there and start creating your infrastructure. Now, if I say PWD, test. Let's say Terraform init. Okay. So if you say Terraform init in the project directory with the configuration files, this will download the correct provider plugins for the project. Okay. So you should run something called Terraform init. Okay. So now, so basically if you have this file called this particular simple EC2 ELB creation template, then it will start creating your necessary configuration files, everything, and then it will start downloading the plugins needed for this particular provider. Okay, provider is nothing but the actual end cloud that you are going to work with. Got it? Now, then eventually once you do that, your next steps are Terraform plan. Plan and apply. So Terraform plan is nothing but to verify the creation process. So for example, if you say you create this template, you use this template and you simply say Terraform plan, it is basically a dry run where it will show the necessary steps that it is going to take during this infrastructure creation. Okay, then so basically Terraform plan is nothing but a dry run. Terraform apply is nothing but creating the actual infrastructure. There are two main differences. One important difference: apply is creating the infrastructure. Terraform plan is nothing but to dry run a template to see what exactly will happen. Got it? That's very important. So that these are the four important steps in the workflow of Terraform. Correct? Next, advantages of Terraform. So while many of the so advantages of Terraform. Terraform is platform agnostic. Okay, I told you what is platform agnostic. Whatever the code and all these things that you are using is useful for AWS, GCP, GitHub, Docker, all these clouds. There are multiple clouds. Once you go, these are all the list of providers that are there for Terraform. Okay. You name it. Basically, any cloud that is there in the market, or any providers that are there in the market, you can create anything. So our interest is pretty much. Can you please go on mute? Okay, I need to mute everyone. So now, okay, so what are the next things? Advantages of Terraform. So I told you what is platform agnostic, which means this whole Terraform, whatever the language that you are doing here, will work for any cloud that you take right now. So I showed you the different providers that are there in the market. So for example, if you take someone like AWS, okay, then this code and everything, whatever the code that is related here, these are all called resources. And the resources and everything, like for example, EC2 resource, document DB resource, ECS resource, EFS resource, all these things you can start creating immediately as you want. Okay, so your job is to go and immediately pick something that you want. For example, EFS, Elastic File System. Okay, EKS. You go here, look into EKS, look into the sections of your interest. Okay, so that is what is platform agnostic. That means it will work for any cloud that you want. State management. Okay. So what is state management? So basically Terraform creates a state file when a project is first initialized. Terraform uses this local state to create plans and make changes to your infrastructure. What that exactly means is, so here if you create a simple example here, like vi test.tf, okay, you say you put something there, okay, and next if I click on Terraform init, based on the provider that you give, it will start creating the necessary sections that are needed for it. And then Terraform creates something called a state file. Okay, so state file is nothing but basically to track the exact state of your infrastructure. So for example, if you see on my screen, there is a CentOS machine. So tomorrow, if I create this CentOS machine with the Terraform, what will happen is that that file is going to, that instance is going to be created through Terraform, and it is going to be tracked by Terraform also. It is very important to remember that word Terraform, tracking through state. Why? Which means tomorrow this instance, if I go and make some manual actions or any changes here, I click start or terminate, or if I make some weird changes on this instance, out of the actual state that it has, okay, Terraform will bring that instance back onto the original state. Okay, so that is the cute thing about Terraform. It will manage, it will track the state of the current infrastructure. So state file is very important. Okay, so that is exactly what is state. Now next thing is operator confidence. What is operator confidence? So basically the workflow built into Terraform aims to instill coincidence in users by promoting easily repeatable operations and a planning phase to allow users to ensure the actions taken by Terraform will not cause disruption in their environment. This word is very important, disruption. Why is it important? So tomorrow when you are creating this infrastructure, okay, now it's okay to create, but if you know that the infrastructure that you are going to create, it is going to create some kind of disruption on the current environment, then you are in trouble, right? Okay. And if it's a new infrastructure, that's okay, good. But if it is going to make changes to current instances, like making some changes to weird changes like security groups, okay, all those things, then you are in trouble. Why? If something changes on the security group, the instance might not work. Right, so your job is to not create disruption through some kind of weird automation. Right, nobody in this world will do something like that. So your job is to have that confidence so that there is no disruption in your environment. That is why you have something called Terraform plan. Plan is nothing but a basic dry run to see what exactly will happen before you apply that infrastructure. That is what is operator confidence. Okay, so that is also very important. So it's basically a plan to create the infrastructure and run a dry run before you create it. Now next sections. So installation, I already showed you very clearly how to create infrastructure and how to install Terraform. And then once it is done, you run something like a Terraform command. You see what exactly you want. And then you run Terraform-help. You'll see some help section. It will show you what exactly it will happen. What various sections of Terraform. And he's asking us to look into Terraform --help. He wants us to look into plan. So once you click on something like run something like this, Terraform help plan, you'll see the various options that are there. The various options are Terraform-help plan, and you'll see some description behind it. This execution plan can be reviewed prior to running apply to get a sense for what Terraform will do. So you can read what exactly that command will do. Okay. Optionally, the plan can be saved to a Terraform plan file, and apply can take this plan file to execute this plan exactly. So these are all the various options before you run Terraform plan. It will destroy a plan. It will destroy everything. What is detailed exit code? You can see some exit codes behind them. So these are all the various options that are there to look into before you create the infrastructure. So that is how you get some help here. Okay. Now, next step is building infrastructure. Okay. So before I dive into actual creating the infrastructure. Okay. Any questions? So before I move on to the next sections, any questions?
No.
So till now, what we did is we did some theory around what exactly is Terraform, how to create infrastructure, all these things. Okay. So now what we'll do is we'll do some basic labs around it. Okay. Okay. So first and foremost, let's create a small sample file. Okay, I use a small editor called Atom. And basically this editor is nothing but to write your nice files and all these things. You go to Terraform, you go to test, and this test file I added my whatever the sections that are given by Terraform guys. So basically what you see here is you're mentioning your provider. Provider is nothing but the respective cloud environment that you're going to use, and the profile is default profile, and region is nothing but the region that you are going to create this infrastructure on. So if you click here, now I am using Mumbai. Okay, so I should give something like AP South 1 because that's where I want the instance. Mumbai AWS region AP South 1. Okay, good. That's where we are going to create it. Now AP South 1. Okay. And what I'm creating? I'm creating an AWS instance. Okay. And the instance name is example. So now I mentioned it as a resource. Now so let's install some basic packages. These are nothing but some custom packages so that your Terraform applets look really, really good. So now I mentioned my provider as AWS. My resource name, see now they are highlighted now. So the resource that I'm going to create is nothing. Resource is nothing but the actual item that you are going to create, which is resource can be anything like. This EC2 instance, okay, S3 buckets, VPC clouds, all these things. Okay, now what I am doing, I gave it as AWS underscore instance. So okay. So now the important things here are, you create your file. It is very important you save it as .tf file. TF file is nothing but a Terraform file. Okay. So now in here, this particular EC2 instance that you are creating, okay, is going to be created on the default VPC in the background. Okay. Now, first and foremost, in US Mumbai region, what you should do is, should come here. Okay. Now, you click on launch instance. And you want to launch instance with AMI ID, this ID. This is where you pick your AMI ID. And you copy here. And what instance you want to create? You wanted to create a T2 micro. Okay. You give the details, T2 micro. You save this file. Okay. Then once you save it, you come back. Okay, so first of all, I have to configure my Terraform CLI. AWS CLI, sorry. I'm just installing AWS CLI. Okay, I have to set up some AWS access keys and all these things. 1 minute. I'm giving my access key and secret key, that's why I had to turn off the screen sharing.
I'm glad you understood now. Half the problem is causing because of your reaction. Just keep it cool, it's okay. Let me get over it. That's the thing, like, you know, don't react. Like, in between. There's something here. There's something about my problem. Like, you're thinking, am I? Don't even write.
No, not after that.
Jesus is there. If you are not reacting to much, then you are happy there.
Yeah, when I'm clear.
It's still installing AWS CLI. Once that is installed, all I do is give my AWS secret key and access key. Then once I give, I'll share it back. Please bear with me a moment. Right, I'm sharing it back. So now I have my AWS CLI installed and working. So if you want instructions on how to install AWS CLI, I strongly encourage you follow this methodology. What do you see here? Use these steps to install AWS CLI. Once that is done, you can simply test it by AWS S3LS. It will list all the buckets. AWS describe hyphen. Will show the information regarding your EC2 instances. Okay, so now once it's all done, once that is done, you want to go back to your Terraform template, and what it is saying is so we set up the AWS profile, AWS CLI steps on these things. So if you follow all these steps, it will say AWS CLI has been successfully done, and within your root directory .aws, you will have the credentials file which will have all the information related to your AWS CLI. So once that is done, you go back here to the provider section that you want. So like I mentioned earlier, provider is nothing but the AWS instance, AWS as your primary provider for creating your infrastructure. Okay. So right now you want to create an instance based off of your AWS provider. Got it? So now I come back here, go to Terraform test. You click on Terraform init. It will pick this particular test.tf file. Okay. Now it will start all the necessary plugins necessary for the Terraform AWS. So now what it did, initializing the backend, and then it is looking for provider plugins. For this provider plugins, it doesn't have plugins needed for AWS. So it installed the plugins first and then started moving on to the next step. So once you once it is done with provider.aws version 2.39, it brought the plugin, then it has successfully initialized. Got it? So now once that is done, what you want to do, Terraform plan. Okay, so what it is saying? Okay, so what it is, when you say plan, this is a dry run. In this dry run, what it is saying is the refer state will be used to calculate this plan, but will not be persisted the to local or whatever it is. And then there is a new plan that is created, and this is of your interest. Okay, the details that are coming here, AWS instance.example will be created. Okay. For this resource, AWS underscore instance, we only passed the AMI ID. Okay. And the rest of the information, the ARN, associated public IP address, availability zone, CPU core count, all these things will be known after you create the instance. Okay. And even the ephemeral block device, network interface, root block device, all these details will be known once you apply. Correct? So till now, there is only one plan. In the plan, it is showing only one to add and zero to change. Okay? And zero to destroy. Now what you want to do? You click on Terraform. If you run on Terraform apply, it will start creating some changes. Okay. So now once you say Terraform apply here, based off of the plans actions, you come back here, and what it is saying, please enter some kind of input. What input it is expecting? Yes input. Why? Terraform will perform the actions described above. So what are the actions that you are that are mentioned here are going to be passed here. Okay, so based off of your plan, whatever the details that you gave there, got it? Now they are going to be created here. So if I say yes, it will do some action. It's look what it is saying. AWS underscore instance, the example is creating. So it is still creating. Now if I go back to my console, EC2, See what it is doing. There is a new instance being created. See? New instance with the details. See, I use the same AMI, all these details. It is still installing. Okay. So now what happened? When I entered yes, it took that information and says AWS underscore instance dot example is creating, still creating, still creating. Eventually it created. So what is the instance ID that it created with? This is the instance ID. Now if I go back onto my AWS console to see what it exactly created, control, I paste it. See, exactly the same instance. It's still initializing, but this is the process of creating an instance. Now let's recap what we did. In this whole process, what we did is we wrote our entire infrastructure through code, okay, and started creating it through Terraform. Now you see the beauty out of Terraform. Like if you write all your steps and everything through code, you can start creating the infrastructure. Okay, so that is the beauty behind it. So this is a sample example of creating a sample EC2 instance for your infrastructure. Okay, so you mentioned your provider. Now I used my provider as AWS. That's why it created AWS infrastructure. But if I say my provider as something like Azure or GCP, it will start creating instances for that GCP, Azure, and all those things. Right? But your job is to provide correct AMI IDs and the instance flavor that you want. Got it? Now, what is the next step? Okay, so let's go through this example. What is this example? So now you understood what is a provider. Got it? So you mention your provider as AWS, and then you have another provider as Datadog. So Datadog will keep your API key and app key that is necessary for your infrastructure. So these values will come from somewhere else. And then you are going to create a new instance. So then what you are doing, creating a simple Datadog monitor. Okay, so this is an instance. What are the Datadog monitor name, type, metric, collect, message. You are going to create a message for it and some escalation message. And this is the query that is needed. It is a hard coded query that is needed for your creation. And then these are the thresholds for your alerts that you want. Okay, so these are all some generic information. And then that is how, so this example, this is how you you are giving all your information regarding your infrastructure. Okay, so this is an example for Datadog, but you don't have to use the same example for your creation. You can use some other example of your choice. Okay, what you should do, you should go back to your provider. What provider? AWS provider. Okay, now this provider has so many things here. EC2 is the most basic thing that you want. So you want to create a resource. So you look into AWS underscore instance. Should click on to resource section. You click on. Okay. So this is an example of AWS instance. So let's go through line by line. What is this? Provider AWS. Region, you want it to be created in US West 2. What is the data? Where do you want it? You want it to use AWS EMI for Ubuntu flavor. And you want the most recent flavor of Ubuntu. Okay. So now, what is a filter? Filter is nothing but to filter whatever you want here. If you click your instances here, there are like hundreds and hundreds of these things, right? See, there are a lot of Ubuntu based stuff, flavors, EMIs and everything. But what you want is, you want it to filter it. So you want under Ubuntu images, HVM, SST, Ubuntu Trusty, whatever this is. So this is a hard coded value, but this is based off of your example that you are using. And then another filter is you are going to go by virtualization type also. Yeah. Okay. So here, this virtualization is HVM. Okay. So that is something you have to look into. And then you give the value also HVM. Honors. This is the AWS ID. What you want? You want to create an AWS instance. What instance? Web instance. Okay. Now, then what is the AMI ID of what you want? Okay. Now, you want Ubuntu AMI ID that you want to use. So what is AMI ID? If you work on AWS, you know that this is the AMI ID. But how will you get it? So what this guy smartly did is, he created a filter when he knows that he wants an AMI ID. See, now I came and copied pasted simply Control C here, Control V there in my example here. But that's not a smart way of doing it. Smart way of doing it is using some kind of proper filters and then pass on that filters here to get the AMI ID. So here you mentioned a data dot AWS underscore AMI dot Ubuntu ID. You will get that instance flavor, AMI ID. And then what kind of instance you want? You want a T2 micro instance. And you want to tag it as hello world. Got it? So this is a sample example of creating an EC2 instance. You should look into it and try practicing this one. Okay? Now, so like I said, what are resources? So resources are a block in a section that will talk about what exactly you want to create. So I come back here, I look here, these are all my resources. Resources is nothing but an actual AWS resource that you are creating. Got it? Now, okay, earlier I showed you a Terraform init command. What is initialization? So this is the first command to run for a new configuration. After checking out existing configuration or version control, you run Terraform init. Why do you need Terraform init? So that whatever the providers that you are giving, the plugins needed for Terraform to communicate with AWS, it is going to install. Okay. And it initializes various local settings also. that is needed by the subsequent commands. Okay, so you should run Terraform init also, and then it will give the plugin version of it where it is pointed to. Okay, now formatting and validating configurations. So Terraform formatting is nothing but basically for properly validating your template style conventions, the language consistency between files and modules. Okay, so basically to what are the file that you create, it is basically it should basically formats it should basically follow the Terraform based language, so that whatever you create, they're looking good. Okay, and then if you run Terraform format, it basically checks that file, the format, everything looks good and everything. Then if it looks everything good, then you run something called Terraform validate to check if there are any issues or any style mistakes or anything like that before you actually create the infrastructure. And eventually, once that is done, you come back, because you know what to do with the Terraform plan. Now you come back and you run that example Terraform apply. And I showed you what exactly it will create with the AMI ID and rest of the stuff. It automatically picks, because you didn't pass, right? It will automatically pick it for you now. Okay, and it planned and executed the plan also. Okay, so the instance is created, application complete. It created the instance, and now you go back to your EC2 console to see what exactly it created. Let's run Terraform show. So this is what it created: AWS instance ID, CPU threads 1. This is because this is a T2 micro instance, number of threads, instance state, primary network interface IDs, private IP, private DNS, public DNS, all these details for this instance, the volume ID. Okay, the security group that is needed for this instance. So it is picking out. See, if you pass all these details manually while you are creating the infrastructure, it is going to create for you. If you don't pass all this information, that is when it will start asking for this. It will automatically start picking it for you. See, you didn't pass, right? But it has to create. How will it create? It is going to go and take those default details. Okay, so now once we created, and when we ran this Terraform apply, Terraform all these details, you remember that I talked about something called Terraform state. So this is the state. So what is state? State is nothing but it will keep track of the current instance information. So you look here, it came the mode managed, the type of instance name, it's an example provider we are using AWS. This is the AMI ID. Okay, this is the instance ARN. If you work deeply on AWS, you know what is ARN, Amazon resource name. Okay, it is created on AP South 1A. So this is tracking all the necessary information related to that particular instance. Now if I go back and make some crazy changes on the instance here, Sorry, 1 minute. What was I talking about? Terraform state. So these are all the, this is all the necessary information for that current instance. Okay. So this is the private IP, public DNS, public IP, all the instance ID, all these things. So this state file is very, 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 very important for Terraform. Okay. So let's run some commands here. Terraform state list. You are managing this AWS instance example. Okay. So this is how you create. So before I go on to the next section, I wanted to any questions? Any questions? So no questions? Okay. If you don't have any questions, let's move on to the next section. So let's take a 5 minute break and then we'll move on to the next section. I keep you on mute. Let's move on to our next section. So we did create infrastructure. We created them, validated them, changes. All these things, we changed the infrastructure. We applied some changes. Now, okay. So we created the infrastructure. And now, how will you destroy it? See, I created it. And I showed you that I'm managing the state here, which means not me, but actually the Terraform by itself will start tracking your file, state file. Okay. So this is the file of your interest, Terraform state file. Now, once this is done, what you wanted to do is, on the same directory where you are working on, you should run a command called terraform destroy for deleting the instance that you have. So now if I run that, okay, it will ask us, okay, what will change now? So before it destroys, it is saying AWS instance example will be destroyed, which means what are the minus symbols all here will be removed out of that actual sections there. Okay. Now, do you really want to destroy all resources? Okay. Now it needs an input called yes. I passed it. It started destroying it. Now I go back here and I refresh my page. See, it is already shutting down. That's the cute thing about Terraform. You create the infrastructure, you manage it, you can update it also, and you can destroy it also. Got it? So this is how it is done. Now, so this is how it will show you all the instructions, how to destroy all that, all those things. Next step is, okay, so let's see what it does. Okay. I showed you earlier Terraform destroy, and I ran that command, it showed you whatever that minus things are, the things that are going to be removed. Got it? Now I came here, and once it says Terraform destroy has been completed, I go back here and look at my instance details here. You will see there is no instance here. Right? It says terminated. The same instance ID which we created earlier. Got it? So now what you want to do, once this is done, let's move on to the next steps. So Terraform apply is for creating the instances. Terraform destroy is for destroying the instances. Destroying the resources that you created earlier through Terraform apply. Okay? So that's very important. Now, next step. Next step is resource dependencies. So this is very important. So resource dependencies are nothing but when you create an instance, and when you create a resource and it has a dependency on something else. Okay, so how will you deal with something like that? So if you see here, you are creating a resource called AWS Elastic IP, and its name is IP, and there is a VPC called VPC is equal to true, which means there is a VPC already, and instance is equal to AWS underscore instance dot example dot id. Okay. So what you are doing here, this is nothing but you are creating a resource, Elastic IP, and you are associating it with an actual instance that is already there. See, earlier we created this AWS underscore instance. So now you are, earlier we don't know if it has an associated Elastic IP. But now what you are doing is you are associating it with an actual IP that you want. Right? So that is very important. So this, the dependency here. So what is the dependency here? You'll see that what are the instances that you are creating. What are the Elastic IP that you are creating should be associated with an instance that is already there. So the dependency here is the instance is the dependency, because if there is no instance, there is no point of associating it with an Elastic IP, right? So that is very important. Okay. So now let's try to. Let's add this to our template. Here is your okay. So let's try to recreate it. Okay, now you have two sections to add. Okay, so now if I say Terraform apply, it will create it and automatically applies the configuration. So it is creating. Okay, so just like what they mentioned here earlier, you are creating the instance and associating it with an actual Elastic IP. That is the dependency. Elastic IP, in case if you want to associate it, you need an instance to associate it with, right? So applying changes, how do you apply? Terraform apply. So now once you run this, so it created it. Now if I go back here and see, okay, so this is the Elastic IP that it is created. So this Elastic IP has a dependency here to an actual instance ID. So for this instance ID, for this EIP to attach it to, we need an instance. So that is the dependency that it followed. So that is how it created now. Understood? So this is how you resolve dependencies. You cannot simply create an Elastic IP without any instance behind it. I mean, you can create it, there is nothing wrong in it, but you expect to attach one Elastic IP to an actual EC2 instance that you wanted to attach it to. Otherwise, there is no use of Elastic IP. Okay. Now next section, implicit and explicit dependencies. Okay, so now, so earlier in the above example, we know that AWS instance needs to be created before an Elastic IP needs to be created. Okay, so sometimes, when you create a template for Terraform, okay, you wanted to create it, but it might not have a dependency somewhere else. Okay, so what this guy is doing now. Okay, so you are creating an actual S3 bucket here. You're creating a resource for S3 bucket. You create the bucket. This is the bucket name and the access control list as private. Okay, so now you are creating another EC2 instance with this AMI ID, and you are giving the instance type also here. So for this instance type that you want, you are creating it, associating it with you are creating this instance, and then at the end, you are saying this section of this JSON, you are saying very clearly, you want this resource to be created only when it is depending on AWS S3 bucket. If it creates the bucket, then only you create this instance. Otherwise, there is no point of creating this instance. Okay, so you are mentioning clearly, you want this AWS S3 bucket example to be created first, then the instance to be created. Maybe the bucket, maybe the instance might be using that section within your bucket. Okay, so the EC2 instance started using the S3 bucket. So that is very important. Okay, if it has a dependency like that, you mentioned that dependency very clearly here. Okay, so this is how you'll make this resource hardware to back to your actual S3 bucket resource. So tomorrow, if you want to create EC2 instance, and if the bucket is not there, this instance won't be created, because there is no point creating that instance and not doing anything with it. Okay. Now, the next step, non-dependent resources. So what are non-dependent resources? Okay. The next one, non-dependent resources. What are non-dependent resources? Okay, so this is another resource. So if I add this instance directly to my template here, okay, it has no dependency whatsoever to any other resource that you are creating, right? These providers, these resources, they have no dependency whatsoever with this resource that you have here, right? So then what will happen, it is independently going to be executed, and that is going to be created. So this instance will be created in parallel with any other resources that you will have, so which is called non-dependent resources. Got it? So non-dependent resources are something where you are creating those resources without any dependency with something else, like S3 buckets or anything like that. Then these things will be happening parallelly with all the other actions in your templates. Got it? That is very important. Next section. Okay, so provisioners are important. Why? So as of now, like the section it says here, we are able to create and modify infrastructure as and how you want it to be created. Okay, if you are using something with a image based infrastructure, you would use something like Packer. What is Packer? Packer is nothing but is something which will create an image out of your infrastructure, image out of your virtual machine. That is when you use Packer. Okay. So if you want to create a instance and you want to do some initial setup on your instances, then provisioners let you upload those files, run shell scripts or install, and trigger other software like configuration management tools. So what exactly that means? Okay, so if you want to do some initial setup on your instances, once they are created, you want to make sure, okay, you execute those things before that instance is used. So what exactly is happening here? So let's go line by line. Resource section, AWS instance, you are creating an instance. you are giving an AMI ID. This is the AMI ID. Then you have instance type called T2 micro. Okay. Then provisioner, local exec, which means locally execute something. So what it says is locally execute on the machine using which is being created by Terraform. What you want to execute? You want to run something called echo AWS instance example, whatever this thing, and run that command. Okay. So that is the example. So what this section is saying, provisional local exec. Local exec means provisioner executes a command locally on the machine running Terraform. So once this block has been run, it will run this command echo AWS instance.example.public IP, and you get that IP locally on your PC here. Okay, so if I say, let's Terraform, just try. I'm just destroying the servers that are created. Okay, it destroyed. So so when you run this commands, you run this file. Okay, so let's see what exactly will happen. Let's add this provision. Okay, while that is creating, let's move on to the next section. So I wanted to execute this command and get the public IP onto a text file. We'll see what happens. Okay, let's create it. Okay, now this is something for remote execution. So what is remote execution? So remote execution, which invokes a script on a remote resource after it is created. Okay. So let's see what it is. So this is common. We are creating a simple key pair. Then you're creating an instance. Okay. And here you are mentioning type SSH root, and you are using the host keys, and you are using now provisioner. Okay, and you are running that remote execute command to run these commands on the instance. Okay, so what will happen? You'll create this key file and then log into that instance and run these commands. So this provisioners that you see here is a remote provisioner. So remotely logging in. So what we are doing here, okay, so what it is saying now. Okay, this particular instance ID is not there. It's okay. Okay, it's creating. So these provisioners are only run after the fact these resources are run. So you should look into this information when they're being created. So you want the resources to be created, then you either you remotely execute or physically log in, physically execute on your local PC like this. Now, see, it created this file called ipaddress.txt. See, it gave me that ipaddress.txt file once I ran this test.tf file. Got it? So what I'm doing here, I'm doing nothing but creating that infrastructure, but I'm out spitting out the IP address of that server by running that provisioner commands locally on your PC. Okay? You can do it remotely also through logging in with a key and then running those commands. Okay. Now, how you run your provisioners? So these are nothing but creating the instance and you expect that IP address file, it created it. Okay. So now, let's not worry about okay. So this is how you use provisioners. This tainting in all these things are little advanced for you. Let's not go into that. And next sections are input variables. Let's see if anyone has any questions. Any questions, guys? Looks like you're good. Next and most important are input variables. Okay. What you are doing all these things here are nothing but hard coding your values here. AP South 1, default name, AP South 1, instance names, all these things. So these are all not a great way of doing things. Okay. What you should do going forward is put variables in your section. So what are variables? Variables are nothing but, instead of hard coding all these values here, you assign some variable name to all these things and then you wanted to reuse them. So something like this, what you see here, this guy, for a region name, for a variable name region, he gave a default value as US-East1, right? He gave US-East1 as the default name for region. Okay, so that is one variable. So using variables in configuration, how will you use it now? You wanted to use it as var.region. So once you mention your variables and you come back and you pick this var.region, it will automatically pick it as var.region here. Okay, so var.region is picked here and it copies that value here, which is US-East1. Okay, now next section is how will you assign those variables? It is very important to create a file called terraform.tfvars. So you create a file with all the necessary variables that you want. Okay, and pass that variables directly here. Secrets.terraform variables, this is a file. This is another file, production.terraform variables. Okay, now next thing. So that is how you create a simple file at terraform.tfvars and you mention all your variables. So what will your variables be? Like AMI ID, instance flavor, region, profile name, VPC IDs, everything can be a variable. So what is the benefit out of variables? So tomorrow, if you want to dynamically change those values, all you have to do is make the changes on the variable section and reapply. Okay, so that is why he is using Terraform apply, explicitly passing the Terraform variables there. Okay, next section is there are environment variables that are already there. So tf_var.region is the region variable for the actual Terraform variable. Okay, so what are Terraform variables? So these are variables which come with the actual Terraform provider, and that is how you use them. I should add a section that I can show here. But these are the variables that come with the actual Terraform provider itself. Okay, now what are lists? Lists are defined either explicitly or implicitly. So which means lists can be given anywhere that you want. Okay, so lists variable CIDRs, which is default one. Now explicitly, you are saying that variables CIDRs as a type list, or implicitly you are mentioning it as a real list, like an array, or by mentioning it through a list variables section here. And then you mention your CIDRs in a terraform.tfvars file, and you mention all the CIDRs that you want. Okay, and next section is maps. Maps are nothing but key value pairs. So this is the key, this is the value. Key, value. Key, value. So within your variable section, you are mentioning your variables as, for you, if it is US East 1 region, you are expecting it to pick this AMI ID. If it is US West 2 region, you are expecting it to pick this region, so this AMI ID. Okay, so that is how you are you are putting all these variable section into your variables file and then recreating it. So then what will happen? Then what, when you are creating the resource, instead of mentioning the AMI ID, what you should do, you should simply say var.amis, which is variables.amis, and you are picking var.region. Now what is var.region? Var.region is nothing but the region of the AWS environment that you are using there. If you are using US East 1, and within that US East 1, it will pick this particular variable, which is AMIID. And next, the instance type is hardcoded T2.micro. But you understood how you are passing all the variables here? That is very important. That is how you pass those variables here. Okay, so this is a dynamic way of implementing things. Okay, so now in here, what this guy is doing is he's simply saying Terraform apply, and he's explicitly passing the AMI's details here. So if it is US East 1, you want it to be foo. US East West 2, you're passing it as bars. Okay, so that is how he is mentioning all the AMIs and variables here. So these are all the input variables for your actual assignment of creating your infrastructure. So these are all the things that you are feeding into your infrastructure. Right? But what are output variables now? Output variables are nothing but what you get out of your infrastructure after the fact you input. Okay, so output is nothing but when you are creating these instances, let's say you created one EC2. Okay, and once you create this instance, output would be an instance ID, something like instance ID. That is something we are not passing in internally, right? We are not passing it. It is being used somewhere, it is being dynamically picked, and then you, if you expect that instance IP ID should be spitted out, then what you want to do, you want to say that IP is being used by us, then you get it as an output variable. So you are mentioning output as IP, and what is the value of IP now? AWS underscore EIP dot IP dot public underscore IP. Then it will pick that output value of that particular Terraform output. So that is how you get the output also. Okay. So that is one important section. So these are useful for getting IPs of, you see earlier we created the output here by IP address spitting it out through some provisioner. But now what you want to do, you want to mention it in the template itself, so the output will automatically come out once you run that file. Okay. Now next sections are a little advanced for the course. let's come. Modules. I'll cover what are modules. Okay. This is important. Modules and Terraform are self-contained packages of Terraform configurations that are managed as group. Modules are used to create reusable components, improve organization, and treat pieces of infrastructure as black box, which means, so these are like, I don't know if you are from a coding background or something, you have something called Python modules, which are actually reusable set of code sections where you use them to dynamically create your infrastructure, right? Reuse the code and create the necessary actions behind the code. Now, what you will do when you are if you are rewriting the code, there is no point rewriting it, right? Because if you have it already in the module section, if you keep on rewriting it, what is the point of reinventing the wheel? So Terraform modules are nothing but where you have some reusable set of code. Okay, so what this guy is doing now, using modules. If you have any instance running from prior steps in the getting started, use Terraform destroy to destroy them. Let's destroy first. Okay, so now Terraform registry. What is Terraform registry? It has a set of reusable set of modules that are already there for various purposes that are there. But in this section, what this guy is doing is he is simply using console Terraform module for AWS, which will set up a complete console cluster. Okay, so what he is doing, Terraform version, this is the version, and this is the AWS provider as AWS. And giving the access key and secret key. And then he is using the module, console module, and creating the number of servers as 3. Okay, so let's see what is Terraform registry first. And Terraform module for AWS. Okay, in here, you can search whatever modules that you want. So let's say if you want something like VPC module. Okay. So this module are useful for dynamically creating VPCs here. So console module. So this is useful for creating console architecture. Okay. So to use this module, so basically this module, console module, in the background is nothing but a long and lengthy Terraform code, but somebody already wrote it for you and we are using it now. Got it? So we give those details here. Now view those details here and then use that information here. Okay, so now if I take all these details and if I simply say Terraform apply, it automatically it will initialize it, and then if I click Terraform apply, it will create all the necessary console clusters in the background, right? And then the output of that console servers will give the name of the servers, name of the servers that were created through the modules. Okay, so if you look here, is clearly mentioning if you use this console module, it is saying name of the clients, region, name of the servers, number of servers, all these things. And for the input section, it is using all these details, EMI ID, SSH key name, VPC ID, all these things. Got it? But this is a little advanced section of Terraform, which I strongly suggest you do it later. Okay? Then once you use that, it will create a console cluster. Then if you click on run a Terraform destroy, it will automatically destroy it for you. Got it? So look into all these modules. I strongly encourage you look into all these modules. The moment you are, if you have familiarized yourself with some basic Terraform, then I strongly encourage you look into all these modules. Because these are very important and a little advanced concepts for you. Okay. And so based off of this, this guy created a console cluster, applied the changes, created it. The outputs are created. We looked into the outputs. And then he ran Terraform destroy. Okay. Now let's go on to the next section. This is all theory, but it's important. So now, till now, what you're doing is you're running everything on your system locally here. Right, so you are creating everything locally on your lap. You are creating everything from your local laptop. That is not a good idea in a production environment. You are expected to create all this infrastructure and everything. The Terraform Terraform machine with a Terraform installed on it should be somewhere on a remote location. Okay, so how do you store a state remotely? First, we'll use the Terraform cloud as our backend. Terraform cloud offers free remote management. Cloud is the best practice for remote state storage. So basically, Terraform cloud is the best option for remote state storage. If you don't have an account, we should start signing up for it. And then once you sign up for Terraform Cloud, it will create an organization for you. It will create a backend for you. So backend is nothing but a remote section. And you give the organization name. Okay. And you should create an example workspace also. If you want to sign up, you sign up here. You create a token because this is for secure access, right? Okay. And you give those token details, everything, and then you start creating your infrastructure based off of it. And Terraform, once you create all these details there, the next step is Terraform Enterprise. Okay, which is very much advanced for now. You should learn how to store your state remotely. This is provided you know some basic Terraform in the beginning. Okay. So what I strongly encourage all of you is do go through all these sections here to understand what is Terraform. So once you understand all these things, then you can correlate your thoughts to storing your state remotely somewhere. And then you can start creating some tokens, start managing organizations. You can start using Terraform Enterprise and all these things. So with that, what I want to do, I want to open it up for questions. What I want all of you to start asking any questions that you have before I wrap up the course. So anyone, Vijay, Julius, Kanchana, Shankar, John, anybody. feel free to ask any question.
Do you, this is Julius talking, do you have any PowerPoint slides that you can give us to follow, because the whole stuff is broad? That would mean that we'll have to just go to the side and read.
I can try and provide that slides after the class.
Okay, that will be better.
Do me a favor. Okay.
Yeah.
So anyone, so please send an email on.
My email?
No, this is my email.
Okay.
Take my email and my Indian phone number.
Okay.
Add me on WhatsApp. Okay. Send an email or add me on WhatsApp. And feel free to ask any questions based off of the course. Email or anything. And then I'll definitely provide that information for you.
Yeah. Thank you.
We already have a group. You want to join that group, Harish?
Yeah, I don't mind.
Mantosh created the group. So whatever you're sharing, you can share with the group.
Okay. You can please add my number there.
Okay, so with we can't see a number. I don't know who can add it. Maybe Mantosh can add, because I don't know, he created the group.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So, okay, Mantosh created that group, right?
Yeah, so if you add it, and then so all of us also will get the benefit of whatever you're sharing.
Yes, 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 I know. I'll do that. I'll check with him.
Yeah.
Any other questions? Okay. So basically, this is an introductory course into Terraform, how to use it, okay? How to spin up your cloud infrastructure, how to manage it with some basic practical labs. Okay, so what I strongly encourage all of you is to do some labs. Okay, so you do some labs, then only you'll understand the beauty of Terraform. Okay, so once you do all these things, some basic management here, write some advanced templates, Terraform templates. That will create multiple resources at once, not like one instance and all these things, like multiple instances at a time, VPCs, all these things. We try to correlate all the information there, which is very useful for you and your advanced learning on Terraform. Okay, so start exploring modules also, which are very important for next level of Terraform learning, because modules are something that are written by somebody else, and you should be smart enough to use all those things. Okay, so with that, I'm actually done with my course, and if you have any questions, feel free to ask me now. Take my number and details, and Mantosh, I'll check with him to add me there. If not, send an email. No problem. Send me an email also. I'll answer my questions there. Okay?
Okay.
Thank you very much, guys.
Thanks, Harish. Bye.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed and learned from this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest. Want to study further? Subscribe to our paid membership to get a deep dive into each and every topic. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to our DevOps School channel and hit the bell icon to learn more. Keep learning.